that doesn't take away from the fact that we're disappointed that we lost the game.
Ben, can I just ask you, there was an incident in the first half with the VAR that you went through. Have you seen that?
I can see that. What I mean is this, it should have been a red, but I haven't seen it.
What's the morale like in the squad? Of course, I know you're happy so far, but how do you stay focused going into the next game?
Just do what we always do. Since September, we play every 3 days, so it doesn't change. It's a big game, Champions League quarterfinals. So we have to prepare ourselves now mentally and physically.
I'm just going to have a quick chat with Matt Ryan, the goalkeeper for Brighton and Hove Albion, of course, see what his thoughts were on tonight's match and also what's next in the Premier League.
Tough game today, obviously, tough result. I think you put on a brave performance though. How do you feel about it?
Yeah, I think us as a club, we can be proud of the way we competed and fought today. I don't think there would have been many people out there that would have given as much of a chance today. And it was just probably the biggest disappointment is how we fell behind so early in the game and put ourselves behind the eight ball. And as much as we tried to sort of manoeuvre our way back around that, you know, that early setback, we weren't able to get back into it. But you know, we left no stone unturned in trying to fight, and if you don't get that equalising goal and on another day, another, you know, bit of luck, a bounce of the ball or, you know, decision with the referee. I haven't seen, you know, the red card incident, but a few people are talking about it. But, you know, on another day, if one of those decisions or one of those bounces goes more our way, then perhaps, you know, we're standing here talking about a different result. But, you know, it's, we set the standard now in terms of, you know, the competitiveness that we need to be showing and that desire and will in these next games. We need to treat every next game that's coming up like it's going to be a, you know, a cup final in order to secure our safety for next season. So it's a good launching pad for these next period of games.
Yeah, if you can take that form into the league, then hopefully it'll bode you well. You could hear the reaction going back to what we were saying about the potential red card incident. You could hear the fans, I think, certainly from our end, how they felt towards it. Having seen the replay, it did look an interesting one. I think a lot of red cards have been given for far less in many other games. A difficult one. Going on to Anthony, obviously picking up man of the match today. I think that shows how well he performed, considering the opposition. Man City is certainly one of the best teams in the world, arguably the best at the moment, would you say?
Yeah, I mean, what they're achieving on the field speaks volume for obviously what they're doing as a club and how big they are as a club and how hard a team they are to play against. So like I said, we're very proud of the fact of the performance that we put in against them, and you know, that's the standard now. We can't fall short of that, and yeah, I think we can, you know, any way we can sort of pick up momentum, I think it's vital in this competition and also in the league. So I think, you know, we can use today as a launching pad for these next up and coming games. And you know, Bournemouth at home next week, if we put in a performance like we did today, I'm very confident that we can get the result. And yeah, Anthony is a quality player, you know. He's very, you know, with his armoury of skills, his trickery that he has, he can, you know, be a tough player to defend against, you know, even for the biggest, you know, and best sides in the league. So, you know, fully deserve the, you know, the accolade of getting man of the match. And hopefully that can give him some confidence also moving forward and help us, you know, achieve that safety.
And you can see at the end, I think you're going to be sending home your fans happy. Obviously disappointed with the result, but they were happy with the performance that you guys put in, and hopefully they're going to go home remembering this day.
Yeah, I mean, ultimately that's, you know, why I play the game, for the club I'm representing, for the area that I'm representing, to try to create as many lifelong memories as possible through, you know, being successful. Today, unfortunately, we weren't successful, but we gave it our all, and you know, I guess it's not so bad a feeling when you know you left everything out there on the pitch, and it's evident that yeah, every individual out there and in the team as a whole did everything we possibly could to try to get ourselves into the, you know, a more positive result. But unfortunately, it wasn't meant to be. But you know, just as much as we're proud of our performance, you know, we're proud of where the club has come from and you know the long history it has through the tough times that it had, and you know, 20, 30 odd years ago when they were last in this situation and whatnot. So it's nice to, you know, be back at, you know, the highest tier of the competition here in England, and you know, competing semi-finals of FA Cups. And hope the, you know, the club and you know the fans and the people of the area are proud of that.
Yeah, most definitely. Mate, thanks so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.